Hello from the Bureau. I'm climatologist Lynette Bedio.
And I'm hydrologist Paul Fakemer, and we're here to discuss the first look at the climate water outlook for autumn. So then, what's driving our climate at the moment? We've seen some remarkable weather in the last 2 weeks.
We have. There's no large-scale processes driving our climate at the moment that's largely neutral. That positive Indian Ocean dipole that we saw last year has gone to neutral. Mm-hmm. We are seeing a little bit of warming in the tropical Pacific there around the dateline, and that can act to bring moisture away from Australia, so we'll keep an eye on that one. But none of those large-scale processes acting. Though, as you say, we have seen some weather in the past week. The monsoon has kicked in northern Australia, so we're seeing some rainfall there. We saw tropical cyclone Damien, and that brought rainfall to Western Australia, though we would have liked to see some more rainfall in the south there for those drought affected regions in the southwest. But we did see a lot of rainfall in the east there, Paul.
Yes, we certainly did, Lynn. And that rainfall, most of it fell to the east of the Great Divide, and that resulted in an increase of over 30% in the Sydney water storages. Mm. Quite remarkable. To the west of the divide in the northern part of the Murray-Darling Basin, we also saw some good falls that resulted in rivers flowing that were previously dry and some widespread wetting up of the landscape, but unfortunately no big changes in water storages within the basin. If we look at soil moisture though, we can see that in January it was relatively dry or well below average in terms of soil moisture. But if we look at more recent soil moisture in the last 2 weeks, we can see that's certainly wetted up. Mm. So what that means is that any rain that does fall from now on is more likely to become runoff. So then what can we expect in terms of rainfall?
Well, with those drivers being largely neutral, there's no strong swings towards above average or below average rainfall across much of the country. We are seeing in parts of northern Australia there an increased chance of above average rainfall and a slightly increased chance of below average rainfall in parts of southern Queensland there, but no strong swings. So with that recent rainfall and the outlook, I can imagine this has impacted on the streamflow outlook, Paul?
Yeah, certainly, Lynn. Look, we're expecting low flows at most locations, although about 30% of locations are expecting near median to high flows, which is better, a more rosier outlook than last month. But what in terms of temperature can we expect then, Lynn?
So like we've seen in previous months, there's a really strong chance of above average temperature across much of the country for daytime and nighttime temperatures going into autumn.
Thanks for that, Lynn. Thanks for joining us. Please keep updated on our website and we'll see you next time.